Hello, you. No, it doesn't work when I do it, does it? Anyway, yes, it's time for Tuber's High Score Challenge again, and once again, as is most of the time, it's a shooter, but not for the arcade, although this easily could have been for the arcade. No, this is in fact Cho Ren Sha 68K, I guess I said it right. Came out in 1995, and was made for it originally, although later on it was re-released for Windows PC in 2001, had some improvements and enhancements. But I worked hard enough trying to get the emulator working long ago in the past, because I wanted to try Sega ports, which it has quite a few good ones for it, and so that's what I'm using here. And, well, I've mentioned this many times before, I'm not great at shooters, and this one is too much for me to handle. I'll just get that out of there right now. I did my best. Also, yes, there's no sound effects, and the music doesn't quite match up. That's because I forgot to turn on the sound for recording this. I've been so used to, for a long time now, recording without sound, I forgot to turn it on. Sorry. So I added some music in after the fact, which, one of the things I do like about this game, because I'm not really a big fan of it, to be honest with you, it's fine. I tried it before in the past, I never thought I'd return to it, just, you know, try it and move on. The music is really good, so hey, it's got that going for it. It's also kind of impressive in a way. I mean, yes, I'm running on an emulator for the old computer, and the emulator is pretty good, actually. But it's impressive that all the crap that goes on the screen, that it doesn't really choke on it, except for a few times you'll see that later on. And, yeah, I don't know, that's about the only other thing I can say about it. The early part here is kind of very repetitive, even for a shooter, but maybe it's just me thinking it's only like that. There's not a whole lot I can say about this one. It's not one I personally am fond of, so it's not like I went deep diving into it, but I did decide on something I could tell you about it. You might find interesting if you didn't know already. It was originally for the X68000, because of its freeware scene. And it was popular for something, I guess this is how you pronounce it, even though it has a thing over top of the one letter. I don't know, I'm not good with Japanese stuff. Doujin, which I'm assuming is pronounced Doujin. I don't know, although it kind of sounds French the way I just said it. Dijon, no. Which I learned a new thing from looking into this, is a new word to me. It means a group who share an interest. It's kind of similar to, in English, which I'm much more familiar with, click or fandom, which, you know, okay. And it's has a cult following, which I've come across plenty of games like that and some R shooters. It's got some pretty big sprites and all that. But in terms of me playing this here, I can't tell you anything that I usually don't say in most other shooters, except for a few I do know well and I can actually do decent in, like Dangerous Seed. I mean, to be fair, I kind of do all right in this compared to some others where I do even worse faster. That's how it goes. It doesn't have any auto fire, so you're mashing manually, of course, which I'm used to that, but this one kind of tires me out more than some others. You do actually get some lull periods, which is kind of nice. And the game is decent enough, I guess you can call it, with the upgrades. And as you can see here, I waste my bombs because I panic and I can't live. Although the funny thing is, in this, you can actually take more than one hit before you die most of the time. You actually have shields you can get, although there's no real indicator for it unless I've never noticed it. I think it might actually be on the ship itself. I'm not sure because, well, let's be honest, when you're playing this kind of stuff, unless you're a grandmaster at it, what the hell are you paying attention to but that kind of thing? You're not looking at your own ship, you're just trying not to get hit. So hey, and there's one of those upgrade things, you break it open and it craps out three upgrades at a time, which, it's been a while since I last bothered with this game, so I kind of forgot about this, but you can actually get more than one upgrade. They kind of phase out as soon as you touch one of them, but if you're quick, you can actually get some more. Which, you know, that was kind of what my main goal here was with this. Every time I break one of those and I get the upgrades, I had to get as many as I can. I didn't really care what I got, it just had to be something, although I kind of was hoping for bombs most of the time, because, well, you see how I go through them like candy. See, I just got another one there, even though I already touched the other thing first. I made it, I was quick enough to get it in time. There's only one or two times here where there's these little enemies that are just appear on the right side there, those things, where they kind of get in the way and I couldn't really get more things like I wanted. I did my best. It's that whole risk versus reward thing. All I know is I had to rely on bombs quite a lot, and right there is a death I could have easily avoided. Because these things here, even though they look big, well, I mean they are big, but I mean they look intimidating, they're actually not that bad compared to some of these other enemies, even I can say that. There's a ton of shit on the screen, to be honest with you. To this day, I still have a problem with that in many shooters. I mean, I don't like bullet hell ones just for how they are, but part of it is also it's just a mess on screen and I just can't discern anything. It's too much for me to... I can play racing games and I can take corners at the high speeds and know when to brake and do this, this, and that. That makes sense to me. Trying to avoid a trillion little objects on screen, forget it. And these guys, by the way, I don't know how to handle them correctly. I mean, if I was playing normally, I would just use, you know, continues in this, which you can't actually, but unless I don't notice how. but you know, there's save states and things, which the simulator works weird with those. But I wasn't doing that here, obviously. And there's one of the times when it chokes on things, but that's a lot going on screen, so you know what, I can forgive it. It's a little impressive in a way, I gotta say. Much like Metal Slug, how it handles all that stuff going on. The music, though, is easily the thing I like most about this one, but when it comes to actually playing it, I'm amused by other shooters and stuff. I don't know, I'd choose some other ones to go with, but it's not a bad game, far from it. It's just not one for me. Or even for the shooters I do like, I just don't get any enjoyment out of it, because the balance between me having fun and just the frustration isn't nearly equal. I do like this boss, how it kind of like is like a half-ass transformer and it combines before it starts annihilating your ass. Which, I'm not sure, if I could probably hold on better before this and save some more bombs and or lives, I probably could handle this boss, but I'm just being honest, I've tried. I did enough attempts at this before I felt I was really tired and I couldn't keep going and trying over and over and over. Diminishing returns, I just couldn't do it. I can't handle it. It's a pathetic run, which is sad given how good I did in the last one, which was a game I'm very familiar with, Dangerous Seed. I mentioned that in the video. And that's easily one of the best runs I've ever done since I've taken part in the 2% high score challenge. Shooter or general, especially shooters, I mean. So, hey, whatever. Anyway, there you go. That's it. It's not good, like I said. I don't think it is. But anyway, thanks for watching, and see you in whatever video I do next.